Students, today we are again going to continue the chapter. Last time we done up to the business model of the e-commerce. Now we have to start with the e-retailing. Now what is e-retailing? The electronic retailing is the full form of e-retailing. It is also called as e-tailing or internet retailing. It is the process of selling the goods and the services through electronic media, particularly the internet. Simply, the sale of retail goods and the services online is called as electronic retailing. Fine. The next topic is how to make and purchase online. Nowadays, we all are doing the purchase online purchasing. So, what are the steps for the purchasing of the any object online? To explain that particular topic, first of all, I have to explain you some points regarding the online purchase. The number one topic is electronic storefront. What it is? An electronic storefront is also called an online catalog. It is the website where e-retailer displays the product. It is an online catalog. You can also call it as electronic storefront. Other topic is shopping cart. The shopping cart allows the customer to collect the items for purchase. The items in the shopping cart can be added, deleted, or saved for the future use. So, to understand the online concept, purchasing concept, you have to keep in the mind these two topics. Number one, electronic storefront, and number two, shopping cart. Now, this is the proper chart, or you can say it is the image which tells you, which explains you the path of an authorized e-retail transaction. So step number one is customer views e-retailer's electronic storefront. Fine. The step number two is he or she collects item in an electronic shopping cart. Number three step, he or she enters his or her personal and financial information on a secure website. E-retailer sends financial information to the concerned bank. Then the step four, bank performs security checks and sends authorization back to the e-retailer. Now the step five, e-retailer's web server sends confirmation to the customer, processes the order, and then sends it to the fulfillment center. Now the step number six, fulfillment center packages the order, prepares it for the shipment, and then sends a report of the server where the records are updated. Now the step number seven, while the order travels to the customer, shipping information is posted on the website. Finally, the step number eight, the packages in the order are delivered to the customer. So these eight steps are there for the online purchasing or the online transaction, e-retail transaction. Now the next topic is, what are the security concerns regarding the online shopping? So online shopping nowadays is very secure and reliable. When you purchase goods or the services online, the vendor asks you to provide payment information. Fine. Now it means credit or debit card number with the name and address details. As it is very sensitive data, you need to ensure that you provide the payment information only to a secure site. Now, here is the term secure site. How you can find out the particular site is secure or not? There are further explanation of this topic. The website and the browser displays various indicators to ensure that the site is secure. Now, what are those indicators? Number one, on the website, look for the HTTPS instead of HTTP in the site address. So, in the address bar, you have to look for the HTTPS, not for the HTTP. If it is there, HTTPS is there, it means the website is secure. Another point you can also check for it is, sometimes the address bar shows a green background for a secure website. If the address bar is having the green background, it means the website is secure. Another thing is, here is the image of the what we have explained you earlier. Number one, you here it is HTTPS instead of HTTP, and secures is also there written, and it is in the green color. It means this image shows that this particular website is secure. Fine. So the third point is look for the lock icon in the browser window. लॉक आइकन मीन्स जैसे आपके ताला बना होता है ना, वैसे ही आपका एक आइकन बना होता है ताले की शेप में. सो दैट इज द सिक्योरिटी कंसर्न. नाउ आई हैव टेकन द इमेज हियर. इट इज अ फेसबुक वेबसाइट. फेसबुक वेबसाइट पे क्या है देखो आपके, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लॉक इज ऑल्सो देयर, सिक्योरिटी इज ऑल्सो रिटन हेयर, HTTPS is also here, and all this is in green color. All the three combinations are here. It means it is the secure website. Here you can also see HTTPS and lock button, or here you are having the lock button. So all these three points are there for the security concern of the website. You have to check these three points for the security concern. Now here you can see lock is there and HTTPS is also written, पर colors का हरा नहीं है. It means ये नहीं है कि ये website secure नहीं है. It is secure क्योंकि it is having the lock icon also and HTTPS is also there. Fine. Now what are the mode of payment for the online purchasing? Mode of payment is a way that a buyer chooses to pay the seller for a good or service that is also acceptable to the seller. Fine. Now there are various ways of making electronic payments, such as credit card, debit card, electronic wallet and net banking. Now what is credit card? Credit card is a rectangular plastic card issued by the financial institutions which let you borrow funds from a pre-approved fund to pay for your purchases. Now debit card. A debit card is a payment card that deducts money directly from the consumer's checking account to pay for a purchase. Now electronic wallet, in short it is known, also known as e-wallet. What it is? E-wallet allows you to store multiple credit card and bank account numbers in a secure environment and eliminate the need to enter in account information when you make your payment. Once you have registered and created e-wallet profiles, you can make the payments faster and with less typing. So this is what? This is electronic wallet. In short, it is e-wallet. Now coming on the net banking. Net banking or banking means net banking or banking online means accessing your bank account and carrying out financial transactions through the internet on your smartphone, tablet or computer. Okay. Now coming on the explanation further for net banking, it's quick, usually free and allows you to carry out a number of tasks such as paying bills and transferring money without the having to visit or call your bank. Now what are the top websites that are having the e-commerce websites? Number one, amazon.com. as you all know, this is a top one of the top website for the e-commerce. Flipkart.com, snapdeal.com, alibaba.com, all these are the top e-commerce websites. Now the further concept is blogging. Blogging, what is blogging? To understand the blogging, let's have to explain you some terms in concern of the blogging. The number one is blog. A blog is a website that consists of a frequently updated collection of information and entries. Fine. Now other term is post. The entries that appear on a blog are called post, and the act of publishing a blog is called posting. Other term is blogger. A single person who maintains the blog is called blogger. Blogging. The act of creating blogs is called blogging. It is a medium by which you can publish your ideas, opinion, and stories online. So I have told you some important definition for the blogging. Number one is blog. What is blog? It is a personal website that consists of information and the entries. Post. The entries that appear on the blog are called post, and the act of publishing a post is called posting. Then blogger, the person who maintains the blog is the blogger, and the act of creating blog is called blogging. Fine. Now, what is blogosphere? Other concept is blogosphere. Blogosphere refers to the worldwide collection of in blog. There are 100 million blogs on the web that you can read. Now, another concept is video blog. A blog that contains video is called video blog. Normally, simple blogs can contain the images. But if they are having the video, then it is called video blog. Now, what are the uses of blogs? It helps you to get a better job by having social network and experience of writing and expressing yourself. You can start a new business by hiring the bloggers to advertise your product or the business. It helps you to become a better writer. You can become a published author also. You can express yourself as an expert. You can, as you are writing a blog, and there are thousands, millions of blogs on the website. So it builds a strong network. And obviously, when you write in the blogs, you can express yourself very nicely. Now, another topic is creating a blog. When you open a website to create a blog, you have to register yourself. After registering yourself on the website, you can write a blog, and that writing a blog is called a post a blog. Jab aapne post likh diya, you have to publish the blog, that is called the posting. And after posting the blog, you can view your post also, and you can also share your post with the other bloggers on the website. So here your chapter is done. I hope you are clear with the concept and understood the chapter nicely. Thank you, everybody.